You'd be amazed at so many people in the world today who think things that they don't do. Meant to do it, never got it done. It's hard to bring something from thought life to action. Maybe it's because we live in a world of procrastinators. People who have great ideas and great goals and great visions and great obstacles and great problems. And so they sit down with their ideals and their goals and say, you know, I'll put it on hold. And they look and the years go by and the hair turns white and the knees get stiff. And they just thought it, but they never did it. See, the older I get, the more I realize that you can't take life nor moments for granted. I can deal, personally, I can deal with death better than I can deal with regret. Whatever I gotta say to you, I'd rather say it. Whatever I wanna give you, I wanna give it. Whatever I need to express, I wanna express it, because the next second is not promised. All you have is the fierce urgency of now, right now, this present moment. You don't have long to get over whatever you're going to get over, climb over your inhibitions or fear. The clock is ticking while you are thinking about it. You are running out of time. There's a rush to do it. There's a rush to birth your dreams. There's a rush to go after your goals. If you don't hurry up and do it, you won't get it done. And the most dangerous people are people who miss their turn. Bitter people who miss their turn will try to kill your future. They will become a Saul in your life, and they will hate you over something that you didn't have anything to do with. They'll hate you, David, over a turn they missed. There is nothing as bad as the sad memories of a lost opportunity. Lost opportunities. It's a gift from God to have an opportunity. When you woke up this morning, God gave you an opportunity. What could be a better gift than to get an opportunity? And what a tragic waste it is to have an opportunity and not use it. Not maximize it. Not live it to its fullest. And to assume you have tomorrow. How arrogant of you to assume that you have tomorrow, when in fact all you have for sure is right now. Right now. Get it right now. Get it said right now. Get it done right now. Open your heart right now. Write the letter right now. Express the love right now. Because if you don't, I can tell you from experience, coffins can't hear. And regret is poor company sitting in a nursing home saying, I missed my turn. I can tell you this, age doesn't give you a do-over. It's terrible to get old and miss your youth. It's terrible to be divorced and miss your marriage. I'm ready to be a good wife now. It's too late. I'd be a great parent now. The kids are gone. They're here a moment, they're gone the next moment. If you don't get it right, you don't always get a do-over. You'd be surprised at the unwritten books in this room. The businesses that are in your head that never get built. The ministries that are in you that are never evolving, never created. The poems you didn't write, the songs you didn't sing, the books you didn't create, the job you never went after, the interview you didn't pursue, the chance to own that you didn't take. This message is for you.
All right, guys, the exercise you just saw me perform is one of my worst ones, okay? I'm still learning how to perform that exercise with proper form, okay? To all of you guys that, you know, you're aspiring to lose weight or build muscle, whatever your goals may be, just because you don't know how to do the movement, you know, it doesn't mean that you don't do it. Show up and practice it, all right? I'm practicing that particular movement because I want it to be a part of my routine, my workout routine, my shoulder routine on Saturdays, okay? But yeah, man, I suck at it right now, but I'm gonna do it until I get it right. Anything worth doing is worth doing badly until you get it right. Remember that.
You better grow up and get to the point as a man that if you ever get beat, you better get beat by somebody that's just purely more talented than you are. You better not ever get beat by somebody because you beat yourself. You have to take advantage of an opportunity of a lifetime in the lifetime of the opportunity. Let me tell you something. You sit in this room, you think you're going to be 18 for the rest of your life. You think you're going to be 19 for the rest of your life. You got an opportunity right now that you won't have 5 years from now. You have an opportunity right now that you will never have. People say, why you grind so hard, E? I might not be the number one motivational speaker in the world 5 years from now. I got to get everything I can get right now. Every book I can write. And listen to me. My school is being paid for by the athletic department. I'm hot right now. Right here. You may never get another one. Some of you, after this, there may not be another opportunity. Let me tell you what I tell athletes. The worst thing in the world is not growing up in poverty. The worst thing in the world is growing up in poverty and coming here and getting worship and not taking advantage of this, and you got to go back to the hood. That's the worst thing that could ever happen to a bro. Traveling and being in hotels and seeing the world and eating like you eating and not taking advantage of this.
Tell you guys that struggle with trying to find out what your purpose is, okay? Your purpose is your gift to the world. You owe me something. I owe you something, all right? I record videos every week and speak life into you. Why? Because that's one of my gifts. It's one of my purposes. Whatever your gift is, it's a gift. It's a purpose for the world. It's not for you. It's not for monetary gain. It's not for your favorite car, the car that you wish to desire, or the house that you wish to desire. Your purpose is meant to help other people. And you'll make a little money or a lot of money along the way, right? So find out what your purpose is. Because you're doing yourself and us a disservice. What's your gift? You owe us something. You know, if you're watching this right now, you got a gift. Just because you ain't big like me don't mean you don't have a gift, all right? I used to wish I was tall. You know, that's not my fucking gift. I'm not a basketball player. Find out what your gift is. If you're watching this right now and you struggle with figuring out what your purpose is, first of all, I just want to speak some life into you. Stop comparing your ability, your, you know, physical makeup to somebody else's, right? Because like I said, when I was younger, man, I used to be pissed off because I wish I was tall. I'm 5'8.5", 9", all right? I'm not the shortest motherfucker on the planet, but I'm damn sure not 6 feet, right? And I used to feel inferior. I developed this inferiority complex against other people that was taller than me because I thought they was better than me or whatever the case may be. Well, shit, I'm 5'9", but I'm strong as shit, okay? If you a skinny guy, that means you're probably fast as fuck. But you too busy worrying about how strong that guy is. You can't develop your gift because you comparing your gift that you don't know that you have to what they got going on, man. Get laser-like focus. Focus on developing your shit because you owe the world something.
They love the process just as much as they love the prize. And some of y'all just want to score. You don't like the process. You're not in love with the process. You just like to put the pads on. You love when it's showtime. Everybody in the car, you like, hey, mom, can you see? You can't even start until you know your people there. Once you see them, you're like, showtime. A real man in the dark, when nobody's watching, he putting in work. A real man, when coach ain't even watching, he studying film on his own. Because he loves the process. If you will be a champion, if you will be a beast, you're going to have to go through something. Ain't nobody going to hand you nothing. Ain't nobody going to hand you no championship. Ain't nobody going to hand you no title. So this is my year. I end. This is my year. Listen to me say.